I am Dr. Henry Chan, and I'm a consultant orthopedic surgeon. You can actually think of me as a mechanic to the human body. My special interest is actually to incorporate technology into the field of orthopedic surgery. So I feel that medicine is actually very far behind the rest of the industry in terms of automation, precision and robotics. We deal with all the bones and joints problem, neck pain, back pain. All this could be related to a spine compression, a nerve compression in the spine. I am the firm believer of technology in medicine. So I do feel that if there's a way that I can improve the accuracy, improve the precision and the results of my patient, I'm willing to go the extra mile to adopt these techniques for my patient. I would say that we are really like mechanics of the human body. So if you can accurately restore the mechanics of the body, the function will be good, the results will be good. Several instances we do hip replacement. The most common instances is hip arthritis, or sometimes this condition called avascular necrosis, or in some unfortunate patient that they fell down and cracked the hip bone and they have no choice but to also consider hip replacement surgery. So what happened is that they lost the ability to move. So instead of the free movement and the pain-free movement, they feel that they are stuck. So hip replacement basically is to remove the damaged tissue and change to the new joint. So this is how we do. So usually we will, the damaged part will be removed, and then we will actually put in a metal stem to anchor, and then we'll put in a new, we call it a ceramic implant. So this is the best implant at this moment. And then the damaged cup tissue, the remnant of the pelvis joint will be removed as well and changed to a metal piece. And then the new joint will be able to glide smoothly again. So basically, text neck is the disease that emerged maybe in the last decade when everybody has a smartphone. The problem is that we are too glued to the smartphone, and then we're using it excessively, because a human body, by right, we're not designed to do such static kind of position for 2 extended hours. And I always tell my patient this analogy. So you have a very big head, and then you're always looking down all the time, so you can feel that there's a lot of tension in the neck region, and this is the term to coin it, text neck syndrome. So basically, there's a lot of abnormal wear and tear in the working population. In fact, the youngest patient I had for such condition is 8 years old. They are as vital as the heart and your blood pressure. I always say that the heart is like the engine, and the bones and the joints are like the tires and the moving parts. So in order to keep going, we need to take care of everything. But I must say that the bones and joints problem are in generally easier to handle, and not so severe like the maybe the heart problem and things like that. Keeping yourself healthy also actually boosts your cardiovascular fitness as well. So I urge my patient to consider the more positive thinking, because a lot of patients will feel that bones and joint problem, I just become a couch potato, I stay at home, I don't walk so much, and all this actually become a downward spiral. Yeah, so the patient in general, they decondition, they lost their muscle strength, and they will find that they're harder and harder to walk, to move, and then from a very simple treatable condition, then they ended up in a wheelchair, and there's no U-turn from there.